You're off the hook.
How come?
I sat down with the girl's parents and I told them exactly what you did. Well, I couldn't lie, could I? They'd find out.
What did they say?
They were okay with it.
Yeah, but what did they say?
They said they were grateful someone tried to help. They said to pass on their appreciation.
It was in my hand, do you know that? Right there. Cut. In the palm. I squeezed on it and I squeezed on it. Then right out of nowhere, it just fucking jumped. I mean, it was dead. And then it jumped. Right there. In the middle of my hand.
That's very poetic, Stuart. But you might want to mail it to someone who gives a shit.
What if she rejects me?
What if she doesn't? Do that again and I'll use the truncheon on you.
Hello, I'm Stuart.
Are you high?
I like hanging out and doing nothing. I like films with subtitles because I'm too lazy to listen. The world is a stupid place. It's overcrowded, but I don't want to change it. Not anymore. I want to be part of it. And I want to do it all with you.
Why are you saying this?
It's what I feel. And I can feel. I do feel.
Stuart, I'm with Craig.
You don't want to be with Craig.
Says who?
Me. It's taken me a long time to see it, but now I do. I'm right for you.
Max, come on, it's karaoke time!
I have to go. How'd it go?
Yeah, it went really well.
She's not dumping the farming, is she?
No.
I don't get it. That stuff always works in the films.
Oh, if you don't mind, I'm going to stop listening to you.
I've been circumcised, see, and Mark's not. And the foreskin, as you know, acts like a protective layer to stop the chafing around the... around the bell end. Mm. What about you two?
Oh, our penises are fine, thank you.
Oh. I feel like the odd one out now.
You feel like what?
The odd one out. Oh. I mean, you've all got foreskins, and I haven't.
Oh. I wish I could help you somehow.
Oh, well, it won't go back, will it?
Hello. Now, I don't know if you're a boy or a girl, but I'm your dad. I'm sorry I can't be with you, but I just wanted to say that I want you to look after your mum for me, and I love you very much, and I wish that we were all together, and I want you to remember wherever you go, whatever you do, I'll always be with you, I'll be with you both, okay?
I'm the award-winning journalist Gary Bellamy. For the last few years, I've been talking to the people of Britain on my award-winning phone-in programme, Down the Line.
Okay, some of BBC 3 and 4, they're always in such small print.
Red lines painted on the side of the road of the curb. You can't do that.
But I thought it was high time I got out of my cosy little studio, made myself presentable for TV, got myself a Bellamy mobile, and actually spoke to you lot face to face. As I meet Bellamy's people of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland.
Singular! Me love you, you know. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, me love that.
Sorry, I didn't mean it to be that hard.
What happened to you?
I thought it was just a bit of play.
Stand up. Listen to me, eh?
Yeah.
Don't you ever come in my
come
in my yard, yeah? Don't you ever come in my yard.
I won't come in your yard.
I'll slap me in my face again.
I'm sorry. Yeah? I thought it was just a bit of fun.
Look at my face. Look at him in high.
I did it because you did it to me. I thought it was a bit of fun.
Don't you ever come in my yard. I'll slap me up on my face again. Sit down. Sit down.
Sorry.
Sure.
So you need to look like you're actually driving the car. It's what they use in Hollywood all the time.
Is it?
And dramas and all that sort of thing. Always. Right.
So Morse, when he's driving around or with some murders, he's in one of these, is he?
Yeah.
On one of these things?
Yeah.
God, it's ruined everything. Hold that. So can I do this? Do that? Whoa. Welcome to Bellamy's People. That would be good, wouldn't it? Because people wonder, how am I doing it?
Yeah, but we want to give you...
This week on Bellamy... This week on Bellamy's People, I'm talking about race. Whoa, immigration. You know what I mean? This week on Bellamy's People, yeah? This is good. I like the low loader. Woo! Hey, get out the way! You motherfuckers!
Don't start the engine.
Don't drive there.
So, in Thelma and Louise, would they have thrown the whole thing off at the end?
Morning, Miranda.
Morning.
I got you a coffee and a muffin.
A muffin as well. Thank you.
Yeah. And I bought you something else. Bought you this.
A present.
Yeah, well, two presents, actually. One's serious and the other one's a little bit jokey.
Ah. Mittens. Lovely. So that's a jokey one out of the way.
No. That's just your main thing. You see, you've got such lovely tiny hands, like a child's hands. I thought they look all cute wrapped up like a sexy puppet.
Thanks, Paul. They're really nice.
Oh, really? Oh, good. Well, seeing as you like them so much, maybe the next present won't be so much of a joke after all. Maybe it'll be a necessity.
Oh, I'm intrigued. Condoms.
Come on, Miranda, put me out of my misery. Even the most expensive ones with spermicide, that doesn't give you a sore throat.
Go away now.
But I was interested by their handsome manager, Simon Fuller.
I like you, Simon Cowell, but you're making a big mistake. I got where I am today by following my nose. And my nose tells me the Spice Girls are gonna be massive.
And my genius tells me they're donkey's cock.
Ha! Don't make me laugh.
Don't ever laugh at my genius.
You're making a big mistake, Simon Cowell. But I admire the way you stood up to me. Maybe one day when you've sorted yourself out, we might work together. Look over there.
Wow. Where did he go?
What do you think, Kiefer Sutherland?
I'm bored, Tom. I'm gonna draw a big cock on Robert Redford's car.
Is that all you guys care about? The next cheap thrill? The next kick?
That's right. When I've done that, I'm gonna burn down Sylvester Stallone's shed.
Unfortunately, that year's Oscars was a veritable spaz fest, with more wheelchairs than the Paralympics. Tom was out-spackered by double-barreled knob jockey Daniel Day-Lewis and his left foot.
The Oscar goes to Daniel Day-Lewis!
Have that. How can you talk of adamant?
Jude, what's wrong?
He said I was rubbish.
Oh, come off it. You're far worse about me. They call me a fat talent vacuum. And you don't see me crying like a big baby, do you? Let's go to lunch. I'll get our coats.
If they don't want me here, I'll go to America. Yeah, I could do the accents. Deputy dog, what's that, Muskie? Yeah, I'll show them. I'll show them all.
So Jude headed off to the States and ended up on Broadway with Kathleen Turner. And because the script demanded it, and because he's such an artist, he got his knob out.
Yes. Hey, mate, can you leave us alone? I'm gonna make a move.
What?
When a girl says a word like piss, it means she wants Jiggy Beast.
Well, how does that work?
It's a rude word. Yeah? It means that she's easing up.
Toby?
I'm just trying to save you embarrassment, okay? You know, you don't want to sit there like a lemon, do you?
We'll see.
Yes, we will. We shall. Ah. Sounded good. Strong, healthy jet. Well, my bedroom is through there. Give me 5 minutes and I shall slip into my pyjamas.
And I'll be through in a minute.
See?
Hello, Toby.
I'm a bit cross with you, actually.
With me? Why?
I was waiting for you all night last night in my pyjamas. You won't let Nathan do a feck in your ass.
Sean, Louis and Reese, what have the nation been talking about this week?
4-year-old girl's depressed. She's a bit down. And she took her to the doctor and he said, yeah, she's depressed.
She tried to slit her wrist with stickle bricks. When I was 4, I used to get randy. I used to rub myself against a chair leg. Honestly, and my mum was going, stop that, it's naughty. And my dad said, don't tell him, don't stop, he's Welsh. He said, don't tell him to stop, because he might go funny in the head. And I think I did it till I was about 14. I would get on a chair leg and rub like that.
That's funny. 58% of swimmers think what helps them go faster?
Engines. I think sharks. Yeah, ask me anything about sharks and I know it.
What's the life expectancy of a great white?
Oh, it depends where it lives.
Reese.
Grown-ups talking.
Yeah. You're just all too clever for me. I don't watch the news. I thought this was a programme actually about cats.